Baratunde Thurston. I mean, he's got a great resume here, but with a name like that, obviously, he can never be president. I mean, a name like Baratunde, come on. To quote DMX. Alright, Baratunde is a conscious comic. He's a vigilante pundit. Not sure what that means, but he's going to explain it. He's turned a Bachelor of Arts in Philosophy from Harvard. Authored three books, nominated for the Bill Hicks Award for Thought-Provoking Comedy, declared a champion of the First Amendment by Iowa State University, and called Someone I Need to Know by Senator, and now Democratic presidential candidate, Barack Obama. He blogs regularly on Jack and Jill politics and the Huffington Post. He's appeared on NPR, BBC, CNN, New York Times, C-SPAN, and The Young Turks.
On the question of what we do when we get power, the answer to my question, I think I'm born on the mic. Actually, I'm born on the mic. I'm not sure. On the question of what we do when we get power, the answer to it is obvious, that we abuse it. That's fun. And when Obama becomes president, birds will say, at least for a few hours. And then we get back to work. Jack and Jill Politics is a black political website. We're proud members of the so-called Afrosphere, which represents a host of black bloggers focused on politics. You got Super Spade, Afro Denizen, and the House Black and Jill Report, I see you up top. All we have is Tisha Steele's Congressional Black Congress Caucus Monitor Report, and more people who are represented here. I want to talk about where we were born out of, and a little bit of the history that Duncan talked about, and where I see what we're doing going. Part of it was just to create a space. It was to create a space for conversation. Many of us were commenting on other sites and wanted to have a home where, you know, that cafeteria lunch table atmosphere where people who shared their experience could feel like, yeah, they get it. I see what's going on. You called out something and they were kind of with you. So there was a sense of community and camaraderie around that, and that role was really exploded. Part of what we do is just call out bullshit when we see it. And there's a lot of bullshit to be called out. There really is. I can't underestimate the extent to which, like, this campaign season in the past year and before that has really excited the members of this community. There's a war in the media going on about representation of us in the media. Those who went to the race and gender panel can see some of what that is. Turned on the most trusted name in the news on the night of the Pennsylvania primary, CNN, of course. And they had a fancy chart. They love their charts. John King loves his maps. I think he wants to date those maps. He's always touching them inappropriately. And they had this chart, and it was Soledad O'Brien and one of the interchangeable hosts that they have there. And they said, here's the question. Will white men vote their race or their gender? Now, that's a stupid question. And will they vote with their left butt cheek or their right butt cheek? There's more going on in the mind of the voter than just that. And then they proceeded to put a little bar chart out. And the answer is they voted their race. We look at the Reverend Knight sort of situation, and we saw, Mr. Stephanopoulos say, Mr. Obama, do you love America? Do you think America loves America as much as you do? This whole misunderstanding of what the black experience is and how to talk about it kind of dominated by people who don't know what they're talking about. They don't know what they're talking about. They're dangerously unqualified to talk. And we shouldn't be shocked, but I think it was very painful for many of us to see, like, this is an indictment of a whole group of people here. This is not presidential politics anymore. This is a culture war, a narrow version of it, focused around this election on this particular candidate and the people that he's sort of a part of. So that was painful. It's also not a shock to see the sanctions that bumped the coverage of the Iraq war, so we probably shouldn't have expected that these sanctions would march us into a legal occupation would do anything better with the issue of race. That's one thing we was going to call that out. One project we did. A wiki to track some of the race-baiting tactics that were going on in the primary, because many people were saying you're making it up. you're super sensitive to black folk. You know, black people get it. I know I get it. Some of my best friends are black. And when you're constantly told that, you know, oppression, like anyone who's been oppressed knows that what's worse than the oppression itself is being told that it doesn't exist. And to have a community organized, crowdsourced, collective information gathering thing for Wiki, where people could identify and call out some of what they were seeing, it gave people a sense of empowerment that, hey, I'm not alone. It gave a single reference point for those in the media curious to look and come and find solid examples. So you've got calling out bullshit, you've got the common community table, you've got holding black leadership accountable, which has been really fun. And one of the reasons we're really glad to have Intuition on board. CDC Monitor is a great source, the Congressional Black Caucus, the Fox debates that we helped stop along with Color Change, the black bloggers and Brave New Films. Give it up for stopping that. But there's more. There's more. And so even after Obama, the CDC is going to be there and not necessarily representing and acting out the role of the people who put them in office. And we're in a unique place with this gathered audience of people who feel somewhat empowered to take that to the next step. Whether it's calling them out with report cards, or financing challengers, or just interviewing them and getting those interviews on camera so people can see this is what happens. So go beyond the editorializing, like, hey, I'm a blogger, I got something to say, read my words, to like, hey, we're all citizens here, let's change the world. That's the kind of step I'm looking forward to, and I'll keep my remarks.